Hello and welcome everybody, I'm Kevin from the Creative at Home team, and today I'm here to show you how to use the tool Google Jamboard. So first of all, what exactly is Jamboard? Jamboard is an online board creation tool that will allow you to make personalized boards in which you can write, paste images, paste media, create sticky notes, anything you want to do with it, really. So how exactly is a tool like this going to help you in a creative project? Well, you see, Jamboard has a very useful functionality built into it, which is the sharing of the board. This means that you can create a board and share it with your workmates to better coordinate a project. So let's get started with it. Well, as you can see, right now we're in the Google Jamboard official website, and the first thing we're gonna need to do is to tap the plus icon to create a board. If you're confused about the word jam and board are the same thing in this context, so don't worry about that. So go right here at the bottom right corner of the screen, which you can't see, I'm sorry about that because my face is there. But you will see a plus icon, trust me, if you go to the webpage, it will be there. So after we press that button, we'll be redirected to the actual board itself, and the first thing we should do is to rename it to something that we can later recognize. And then we should select the background. As you can see, there are various pre-made backgrounds, but if you don't like any of these, what you can do is to press this button and search the web for a background or your own computer for a background. I'm going to search my own computer, I'm going to add this background right here, and perfect. Now, as for the tools that we can use in the board, we have first the pen tool. This is your normal drawing tool. It can be a marker, a highlighter, a brush, or as I said before, a pen, and all of these can have various colors. You can draw lines, make arrows, whatever you want to do. Now, if you want to erase those lines, you can choose the next tool, which is called the erase tool. Just a simple eraser, it will just erase anything you have previously drawn. Now, the select tool will be used afterwards when we have something to select, because you cannot select a drawing. You can only select, for example, an image, a text, or a sticky note. Speaking of which, the next tool available to us is a sticky note tool. Now, this window will appear once you select the tool, and here you can write whatever you want, and after that select a color. You can do this multiple times in a row or only once, and then once you have the sticky note, you can change its size or rotate it, whatever you want. As you can see, by clicking here, I'm using the select tool that I previously mentioned. Now, next tool available to us is the add image. Add image works exactly the same as add background. You can search the web for an image, or you can search your own computer. So I'm going to select our own beautiful logo right here, and there it goes. And you can do the same as with the sticky note. You can resize it, move it around, whatever you want to. Now, this tool called circle, more or less like the pen, is not only a circle, this is a general shapes tool, because if I press that arrow, you will see that other shapes will appear. So I'm going to create a rectangle here. And now the next tool will be the text box. This is more or less like the sticky note, but it doesn't have a background, it's completely transparent. So hello world once again. And the last tool is only useful if you are doing a presentation, because it's the laser pointer. As you can see, it disappears. This is used when you are doing, as I said, a presentation, and you want to highlight a part of the screen with this laser. And that would be more or less everything. That would be Google Jamboard. I really hope you liked this tutorial, and if you did, please head on over to our website at creativitycluster.eu to see more tools such as this one. So, as always, have a wonderful day.